Music Access. It's the last day of June today and the last day of the first half of 2015. If we compared this with school, it would be around the time we got our first semester report cards, right? How do you think you did this first semester? Did you do very well? Did you get an A+? What about just average, like a B? If not, will you need to try harder next semester because you got a C-? Let's think about our first semester grades today, shall we? We are back, and the first song you heard today, Tuesday, June 30th, 2015, was Rude by Magic. What's up, Music Access fam? It's me, DJ Benji, and it's the last day of June this year. If you could put a grade on how you did so far this year, what grade would you give yourself? I'd give myself a 10 out of 10, because I'm perfect! No, that was a lie. I'd just give myself 10 out of 10, you know, just to give myself a little bit of positive feedback. What's wrong with that? Anyway, so you guys think about it too, and let me know how you feel you did in the first half of the year on our message board. Going back and evaluating how you did on something helps you prepare for what's coming ahead, right? You can also let me know what you're up to right now or what your plans are for today too. We'll talk about everything and anything on message time. Alright, so let me tell you what's up for today. For our first hour, we have our daily corner that allows you guys to travel back in time, Time Traveler's Mailbox, and All About Music Quiz Season 2, Benji Style in store. And in the second hour, a corner to select music to fit a certain theme or situation. Men of Music will have Sam joining me in the studio for that in just a bit. Before that, here's how you can listen and participate. If you have a smartphone, you can download the Arirang Radio app or TuneIn Radio app and listen to our programs and send in your messages in real time. Or if you use a computer, just visit www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess to listen to us or leave your messages. Another way you can tune in is through terrestrial DMB, but this is only available for our listeners living on Jeju Island. The frequencies are 88.7 for Jeju City, 88.1 for Seogwipo, and 101.9 for Daejeong. And remember, if you have any songs you want to hear today, or maybe a song you want to let someone hear as a gift, go ahead and send those requests onto our message board with the subject title, Request. Alright, we'll come right back after a song for message time. The song is Boom Clap by Charlie XCX. We are back and we just heard Boom Clap by Charlie XCX. And now it's time for message time. And our first message comes from Reem Waleed from Canada saying, how are you on this fine day? I am good, a little bit sleepy, but that's okay because I got my coffee in the studio with me. I don't know if I'm allowed to say that, but yes, it's good. I was trying to quit coffee, but you know, I can't really quit it. I guess it's an addiction. Not really, but I like coffee. Shreya Talukdar from Bangladesh saying, Benji, my 2 weeks vacation is finally over, and I am back again on MA to listen to your voice. Do you still remember me? Yes. Haha, how are you, and what's going on MA these days? Seriously, I missed you a lot. What's going on MA? We have corners, we have me, we have great music, and my DJ voice is improving a lot. Like a crazy amount. It's crazy. So yeah, all about that voice. Angel from Canada saying, hi, how are you, Opa? How is the weather there? Today where I live in, there has been a forest fire, I think. The air has been very smoky the whole day. Okay, bye. Benji Oppa, fighting! Let me think. Today the weather is kind of cloudy. It is quite cloudy and, it's hot but cloudy. Like, that's the only thing I can say. It's kind of a humid day overall. Vanessa from Canada saying, hi Benji, how are you? I hope you've had a great first half of 2015, and I hope the rest of 2015 is good to you and the rest of BIG. Thank you. I think my first half of 2015 is great, and the rest of 2015 is amazing, because of course we're going to plan on having a comeback, so you know, keep all that good stuff coming. Kirsten from the USA saying, when I was younger, 4th of July was a really big deal, and I used to love the downtown parade. The most memorable part was probably the Seafair Pirates, then the reenactment at the landing and fireworks into the night. In recent years, I haven't really celebrated much since I've been away working or studying, and 2 years ago, I was in Korea, so 4th of July wasn't a thing. I did get to see fireworks at the Squid Festival and Ulleungdo, though. This year, there will be no festivities because I will be on stint and working camping. Ah, well, it'll still be a good time. I'm sure it will. She's talking about the 4th of July on Saturday, which is in the States Independence Day. But here in Korea, it's not quite like that. But, you know, all in all, it'll still be the same day for me. Yay! Because I'll be doing music access and training and preparing for all the stuff coming up soon. So, hopefully, gotta store my energy for the week, so on the weekend I can practice super hard. Alright, before we get to our Time Traveler's Mailbox, let's check out a song. The song is Don't by Ed Sheeran. Traveler's Mailbox. Our special corner, Time Traveler's Mailbox, will let all of you bring back special memories by revisiting your past. First, write down the date that you want to time travel to. Then, let us know why you chose that date and where you'll be, what you'll be doing, and who you'll be with when you travel in time. You can also tell us about what's going on today, because it doesn't matter what time we're traveling to. Just write down what's happening in the past, or what you want to happen in the future, or what's happening right now, and send the message to us. Here's a tip, this corner is great for birthdays and anniversaries. Just think about it, if you write about a test you did especially well on in the past, you can get congratulated on it once again, or you can relive the special moments that you spent with your friends and family. You can even go back to a memory that may have hurt you, and talking about it might be healing for you. You'll never know. If you want to participate, just write Time Travel on your title and send us a message on our message board. And our first time traveler is Angel from Canada, saying, hi, I want to travel into the future. Actually, just about a week from today, we're going to Edmonton with a bunch of family friends, and we're going to ride roller coasters and go swimming at the water park. It will be so much fun, I can't wait to have some family time too. Have a fantastic Friday, fantastic, today's Tuesday, Benji Opa. And, wow, I want to travel to the future too and go to a water park. I'm sure it will be super fun and I could go enjoy the cool water in contrast to the hot weather. And it will be, of course, super, super, super amazing time. And I'd probably go with my BIG members and, let's see, who would have the most fun among them? I feel like among the BIG members, maybe Gummin might have the most fun. But besides that, I feel like Hido is gonna turn really dark because he already has that kind of brown skin, but I'm sure if he spends the day at the water park, he'll become invisible at night, so, you know. Hopefully, he'll put on suntan lotion if we ever get a chance to go ever. Hopefully soon. I really want to go. Alright, so now let's check out a song before we come back with another message for our Time Traveler's Mailbox. The song is Just the Way You Are by Bruno Mars.
Just the way you are. And when you smile,
we're back, and we just heard Just the Way You Are by Bruno Mars. And now, continuing on with our Time Traveler's Mailbox, let's meet our second time traveler, Michelle from the Philippines, saying, I always think to myself I should have left the house 30 minutes earlier. I have to take the bus to school, and I always find the bus leaving right as I get to the bus stop. If I miss that one, I have to wait for the next bus, and it always seems to take longer than usual when I'm waiting for the next bus. Just because I miss the bus doesn't mean I'm lazy. I always wake up to the sound of the alarm clock, and I don't take too long to prepare either. It's just that there's so many members in our family that it's always really hectic around the house. It's always really hectic around the house in the morning. We have to wait our turn to use the bathroom or the hairdryer and stuff. And we also have to help the younger ones prepare. This all takes time. If I could go back in time, I would actually want to be born as an only child, but here I am regretting not waking up 30 minutes earlier. I'll probably end up missing the bus by a hair. You know, I think that's a problem that everyone deals with. Like, I deal with it too. You know, when I would have to wake up in the morning, I set my alarm actually for 20 minutes before I actually have to wake up, so I can hit the snooze button and keep hitting it a few times, because if I go like that, it feels like I'm sleeping a little bit more, even if I'm not. There's these little tips and tricks you learn throughout life, but I'm pretty sure you'll find your own way to deal with it, and it'll be super effective. So, Michelle, good luck on that. And, you know, only child, you know, I am an only child. But as an only child, sometimes I wish I had siblings, too. So, enjoy your siblings as well. I'm sure you guys will be a great family, and supporting each other should be amazing. Alright, so thank you everyone for filling up our mailbox for Time Traveler's Mailbox, and hopefully it'll be filled up again tomorrow. Remember, if you missed the date to congratulate someone or propose to a loved one for the future, or if you have any plans for the future that you want to share so you'll make sure they'll come true, all you need to do is send us the letter to Time Traveler's Mailbox. Come visit us at www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess and leave me a message on our message board with the title Time Traveler. Alright, we'll come right back after a song for All About Music Quiz Season 2, Benji Style. And the song is requested by Reem of Canada, Battlefield by Jordan Sparks.
Better go and get your
music and all about quizzes, a great collaboration of music and quizzes, all about music quiz. There's something you guys need to focus on during All About Music Quiz Season 2, and it's Benji's hint. I'm gonna be giving you guys a really critical hint, but there's nothing really set on what kind of hint it'll be. I'll be thinking about what kind of hint to give you guys after checking out today's answers, so it'll be very impromptu, very cool, very Benji-esque. And so make sure to look forward to my hint every day on All About Music Quiz Season 2. Listen carefully, and if you feel like you know the answer right, answer on your title and post it up on our message board. As always, we have a special gift for one lucky listener who sends in the correct answer, and our AA Music Quiz present is Walk the Moon's album Talking Is Hard, provided to us by Sony Music. So, today's AA Music Quiz answer. Ah! Today's hint is the title of a song, and it has to do with what we talked about during the intro, a little bit. So the first hint will be short and sweet, and you'll probably know it as soon as you hear it, so listen carefully fast. Music, please. It's not working, so stop fronting. I know you want me, let's start talking. Oh, we can't hear any more than that because it'll give it away. But I'll give you a hint, it's not H or G or F or E or C. So if you know today's answer, write answer on your title, and remember, it is the song title. Alright, now, before we come back with the second hint for AA Music Quiz, let's check out a track. The track is 잘 됐으면 좋겠다 by 홍대광. We're back, and we just heard 잘 됐으면 좋겠다 by 홍대광. All about Music Quiz Season 2, Benji style. Our second hint is Benji's hint! So, there's something that just struck me as soon as I heard today's title, and I'll express it for you. Can I get some reverb, please? Cool, okay. Benji's hint, are you ready? It goes on three. 1, 2, 3. Alright, so if I was to write what I just shouted out using one letter, it would be today's answer. Remember, it's not Z, Y, X, W, V, U. What comes after U? A, B, C, D, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U. T, S, R, Q, N, M, L, O. I don't know how to do it. So if you know today's answer, write answer on your title and send us a message with the correct answer. Remember, it's a song. If you think you have the answer, come to the Music Access message board at www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess and leave your answer there with the title answer. Our AA Music Quiz present is Walk the Moon's album Talking Is Hard, provided to us by Sony Music. And before we move on, let's check out a song. The song is Cool Bomb by Sleepy and Songjin. We're back, and the song you just heard was Cool Bomb by Sleepy featuring Songjin. And it's time for message time. Our first message comes from Amanda from Malaysia saying, Benji, I missed you so much. Sorry I haven't been tuning in lately, busy with work. Starting tomorrow, I had to work 13 hours for 3 weeks. Salya Joe. I didn't even get enough sleep lately, and my colleagues said that I looked like a zombie. I'm doomed. Doomed for what? Zombies are very cute. And of course, when it comes to that sleep, you know, getting a lot of sleep is very, very important. You know, you need to sleep so you can focus. And, you know, all that busy, busy work day, if you don't get sleep, you can't operate. So, of course, you know, I know that it's hard to find sleep when you're super, super busy. But when you do find the time, try to get that sleep in ASAP for as long as possible. ASAP, as soon as possible, for as long as possible. For ALAP. Brianna from the USA saying, if I had to grade myself on how I've done so far this year, I would give myself an 8 out of 10 or a B-. I was really proud of myself for attending citywide science fair and making the school soccer team. I hope I can continue to be proud of myself as school starts again in the fall, and hopefully I'll be able to make the volleyball team. Wish me luck. Love you. Making the school soccer team and making the volleyball team. Would you be able to do both of them at the same time, though? I feel like that would be super, super busy and, like, there's so much to do. And besides that, you know, attending the citywide science fair, there must have been some interesting stuff that you saw there, you know? What was in there? You know, there must, did they have the classic volcano and vinegar baking soda thing? Or did they have, because I remember when I was in elementary school, I did like a popcorn experiment, which was very successful and a lot, very delicious because I ate a lot of popcorn. Mara from the USA saying, my grade for the first half of the year, 0 out of 10. I haven't accomplished anything that I wanted to, but I've had a lot to think about while visiting my family, so once I get back to Seattle, I have one very major thing that I'm going to do. Whether it pans out well or not, I don't care, but I know I'll do it, and it will be one less thing on my bucket list for the year. I don't know what it is, but let me know what it is in your opinion, because I am very, very curious. And, you know, 0 out of 10, it is a little bit of a stretch, but, you know, thinking about the best things that could happen, at least there is definitely room for improvement, right? So good luck, Mara. I hope everything pans out perfectly. And Dina from Indonesia saying, it's already the end of June? Wow. I didn't realize that until I saw the calendar on my desk. How are you, Benji? Anyway, do you have monthly plans every month? If yes, let me know about your July's plans. Thank you so much, handsome Benji and Dina from Indonesia. Let me think. Do I have any plans for July? I don't have any really specific plans for July as of yet, but I'm hoping that within the month a lot of good things will happen, and besides that, just that I'll get a lot of the goals that I want to accomplish done, again, ASAP. Nia Boo from the USA says, a rap for Benji. Alright, so, I guess I have to wrap this. Alright. Yo, Benji, I wrote you a rap. Yo, yo, don't worry, it's not a trap. Come on, come on, just give it a go. Swag King, show us your flow. Every week, I'll write you one, so we practice a ton. Do this, I hope to improve, work hard like boys and groove. M.A. fam, I will show you much love from Nia Boo. Check it out. Yeah, that's how you do it. That's pretty good, actually. I think it's kind of fun just kind of reading a rap that someone else read out, because it's the rhythm is all my own style. I can read it however I want it. And yeah, it was pretty cool. Nia Boo, I congratulate you on your efforts. You did a very good job. And yeah, next time I'll be expecting another good rap. Continuing on, we have Yunita Suino from Indonesia saying, plus minus on our first semester. Hi, apa kabar, Benji? Means how are you? Tuesday will always be my busy day, but listening to your voice cheers me up. Plus, I went to Korea for a vacation with a free round-trip airplane ticket from KTO. Yay! Another plus is I'm being a loyal listener of Music Access. True. Minus, I met no one in MA family because it was transition time from Aaron to Benji at the time. Plan, I want to go to Korea and meet you all, MA family. Benji, Gihun, Tasha, Jane, Zeno, Karen, Sam, and of course, all the awesome staff. Whoop whoop, Benji and MA family. Cha-chang! That's pretty good. Although it was unfortunate that you did not get a chance to see the MA family in person. Hopefully, if you get a chance to come again, you will get that chance and we'll hang out and have a lot of super duper, super amazing fun. Whew! Alright, now let's check out two songs before we come back with more. The first song is Love Me Again by G-Soul, followed by 그리고 안녕 by 이승기.
Again, baby, love me again, again. How can I need you to love me, baby, love me. 작은 너의 입술만 꼭 너만 듣게 돼.
back, and the song that we just listened to was Love Me Again by G-Soul, followed by the song by Izungi. And it's time to wrap up our first hour. We'll have Sam in the studio soon for Men and Music. So to wrap things up, I'll let you hear Someone's Watching Over Me by Hilary Duff, requested by Yunita of Indonesia. And be right back. What's up? Music Access with me, Benji of B.I.G. And on our second hour for today, feel the excitement of choosing the perfect song with Sam on Men Music in just a bit. But before that, here's how you can listen and participate. You can download the Arirang Radio or TuneIn Radio app on your smartphone. And you can also send us messages through the app using the comment function. Y'all can also listen to us by visiting our website, www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess, and leave your messages there on our message board. Another way you can tune in is through terrestrial DMB, but this is only available for our listeners living on Jeju Island. The frequencies are 88.7 for Jeju City, 88.1 for Seogwipo, and 101.9 for Daejeon. Now we're going to check out a special, classy song, and be right back with Sam to start off our Tuesday corner, Men and Music. The song is Calling Me by Sam. Sam, a guy with his own music studio.
And Benji, a guy with perfect pitch, have got it together.
There's so much we want to talk about and so much we have in common, so we'll try to put that all into
Men and Music.
Yo, what's up, Sam?
What is good, Benji?
Yo, how was your week?
It's been a pretty busy week.
It has.
New album just came out.
And woo!
You were in Japan.
Yeah.
And we're just everywhere.
Yeah, we international, man. We global. Shout out to Cali. I'm just kidding. I don't know. Okay, so you have a new song out.
Yes.
It's called Calling Me.
Calling Me. Yes.
And did you write the song as well?
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about it.
I wrote the song a few years ago. It's based on a true story, but I had to change up the story a little, just the ending a little. I got into a bus and there was a very beautiful girl on the bus, and we actually got a chance to sit next to each other, but she fell asleep on my shoulders.
She fell asleep,
but you know when you wake up, it's like you're embarrassed, you know, you should be blushing. It's like, "Tingpia, God, you're embarrassed," but she looked at me, she was just like, I'm like, what?
Explain what that is. I don't even know.
She was looking at me like, "Oh, yeah, I know you like that I fell asleep on your shoulders." I'm like, what? And then the real story is I just had to get off the bus, and I was just thinking about her the whole day. Because I was embarrassed.
Yeah.
But they're in the music. It's like, she was so pretty, she looked at me, and I got her number. And then at night, she's calling me. That's how the story changed up a little. Because I needed a little fun in the story. So, but yeah, it's a true story. And she was really beautiful. I mean, like, I was kind of shocked. I was
like, really?
Yeah, because she fell asleep, and then she woke up, and she looked at me like nothing happened with these glittering eyes.
Why would you just get off the bus? Why would you be embarrassed? That's her job.
I know what to do.
I mean, you know, a girl wakes up on your shoulder, she gives you this look,
it's the look.
Then you don't go, chuzumda, and get off the bus. You go, hey girl, yo shawty.
That's the Benji move.
That's actually, I wish that happened to me. Alright, so it's time for us to get into our corner, Men and Music, aka Eminem.
Eminem.
Yo, lose yourself in. No, I'm just kidding. But before that, let's take a look at where we stand right now in terms of our, music battle. So you and I, Sam and I, have both won once.
Okay.
So we're tied at 1-1.
1-1.
And the first person to have 5 wins will be the winner. And the loser promised to wear a penalty outfit decided by the winner, right?
Yeah.
You know, I'm just making sure keep things straight so later you don't have any, room to complain when you lose. All right, so let's get right into our corner. You remember from last time, we asked our MA family to send us topics for our corner, Men and Music.
Yes, we did.
And a lot of our listeners have sent in various topics, actually. So don't worry, we've been reading every single one, and we'll be incorporating your ideas into the show. And today's topic actually has to do with the situation that our listener, myself, in the Philippines sent us.
Myself.
Yeah.
So, Sam and I will be acting out the situation in just a bit. But here's today's topic.
Doom.
Which is kind of similar to your story.
Oh, it is. It's eye contact.
It's that kind of, you know, the look that, you know, two people give to each other.
No, but she really gave me an eye contact. I think this is exactly like, it was eye contact.
Wait, so it wasn't like, oh, hi. It's not like, it's like, oh.
No, she looked at me. She was just like,
wait, she did that. She did the whole,
I don't have to apologize to you or be embarrassed about what I did because you're happy too, right?
Yeah.
She had all of that in her face, and I was just like, whoa. She was strong. The aura around her was just like,
yo, you gotta grab a girl like that, man.
Yeah, but I couldn't, so I was just dreaming about calling her. She's calling me, she's calling me now.
Oh,
so like
woohoo, that's hot.
Yeah.
Alright, so some people actually have a hard time making eye contact, especially the introverted ones. You know, they say it's kind of difficult.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess now you're officially introverted because you can't return to your own space. I mean, you know, it's true though, right?
True,
you know,
yeah.
Some people, you know, it also depends on, you know, who you're looking at.
Yep.
You know, you don't look at your, you know, your jueza depo, your jueza, your company head and be like, yo, what do you want? what do you want to eat? It's not that it's like, oh, you know, oh, what do you want to eat? You know, let's get something, you know. And some people also say that if you make eye contact, the other person thinks you have a crush on them.
That's what I
so
thought.
So they try to refrain from it. This
is exactly it. Wow, this is crazy. I can't believe today's topic has something to do with the music.
It kind of is crazy.
Yeah.
So then, let's say I really like, she's gorgeous.
Mm.
She got the whole, you know, the lines.
Mm.
She got the curves.
Mm.
She got this, like, the personality.
Mm.
Can you look at her straight?
Oh, no, it's like, if I'm ready for this girl, I'm very straightforward.
You're very straightforward.
But the bus thing was too,
like,
all of a sudden.
You weren't ready.
I wasn't even ready for that. I was like, whoa. And when I got on, it was just a lot of ajummas and harawajas and ajushis. But right in the middle in the back seat, there's a girl right there. I'm just like that. And there was only one seat left for me, and it was right next to her, too.
What if that was, like, your supposed to be future girlfriend, and you just totally missed it?
That would have been awesome.
That was the love of your life.
Because she looked very pretty.
Next time, take a picture. Alright, so if you keep meeting someone's eye, what goes through your head? Just like a random person.
We both have interest in each other.
Mm, what if it's a guy?
We both have interest in each other, but it's not in a
not in like a very guy, you know, romantic way.
Yeah, yeah.
Just kind of like, you know.
Who is that cat? Who is that, bro? Oh, I was about to swear right now. Oh,
Sam, you gotta watch your language. This is a family.
I was about to be like, who's that? Oh, wow.
This is a family program. So, okay, so what if it's a gorgeous lady?
I'll just keep staring at her. It's not even once in a while eye contact. It'll be just like eye contact straightforward.
So then I want to ask you a question.
Uh-huh.
When she was sleeping on your shoulder, how many times did you look at her?
Oh, no, I couldn't look at her.
Uh-huh.
I was looking at her, like,
reflection.
Reflect her legs and, like, the side of her. I was like, no, it was pretty embarrassing. It was crazy, man. That's why I had to write a song about it, because it was such a crazy experience.
I need to start riding the bus, man.
No, what do you do? Do you make good eye contact with girls?
I make great eye contact with girls. I mean, no, because the thing for me is, it's not about so much, you know, embarrassment and all that stuff.
Uh-huh.
But, you know, it's natural to meet eye contact.
Uh-huh.
And I think one of the best ways you can connect with someone without saying anything is eye contact.
Yeah.
You know, the whole, you know, the eyebrow motion.
You know, even young kids, when they do something bad,
mm-hmm.
and then they're scared to, like, when they get confronted by their parents, they're like, they can't make
They give
eye
you the look.
Yeah, the look.
You know, there's a term for that in Korea. They call it nunchi.
Oh, nunchi. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, they don't have that in the States, though, I think.
Well, they don't.
There's not, like, a specific term. Like, you can't directly translate it, but it's, like, unspoken, optical conversation. I don't know how, you can't
phrase
it.
That sounds pretty legit for
But you know what I'm saying, right? Anyway, so, Sam, of course, you know, we have our song that we're just going to, you know, throw out there for eye contact. So, what song did you pick that you want to share?
For eye contact.
For eye contact.
What song did I pick? Hold on.
You picked...
Akon, Beautiful.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Why'd you pick it?
It's like, when I meet people who make eye contact, it's either I keep making eye contact with a person because I think that person's beautiful as a person, or just I want to get to know that person. Because if I have no interest, like, I don't think I would even make the second
eye
contact.
Of course.
So, just something right out. I really like Akon.
Ah,
his hooks were really great. So
true.
Going back to old school, Akon, Beautiful.
Is it that old school?
It's pretty old.
2007? No, it's not. Because Convicted came out in 2007 or something.
It's still like 5 years ago.
Oh, dang.
These days, 5 years
ago. Akon's old.
Yeah, he is old.
Alright, so the song that I chose, of course, for Eye Contact, if I'm making eye contact with someone, there's one thing I want them to do for me.
That song.
I want them to look at me. Look only at me.
I actually did that song for a voice career.
Really?
Yeah, that was one of, that was my first live performance song.
How was it? Can you sing a little? Did you sing the same way or like you mixed it up? Or?
Yeah, I had to do a lot of remix there. I don't want to sing it again.
Okay.
All right.
The song Sam chose was Beautiful by Akon, and the song I chose was Namambarababai, of course, Taeyang. And so, I think we, talked enough about it. So let's check out both the songs we selected, starting with Beautiful featuring, who was the feature on the song? Colby Adonis.
Yeah.
That's right. Beautiful by Akon featuring Colby Adonis, followed by Namambarababai, Taeyang. We're back, and the two songs that we just listened to were songs that we selected based on today's theme of eye contact, and the songs were Beautiful by Akon featuring Colby Adonis, followed by
Namambarababai,
Taeyang. And now we'll get started on Sam and Benji's music selection battle, where, of course, we act out a short skit related to today's topic of eye contact. And then we'll choose a song that fits a scene from the skit, and our producer will choose which song fit the situation better. So, the situation we're going to act out today is from our MA family member, Myself, from the Philippines.
Myself. And,
can you share what she wrote?
Here it goes.
Woo!
Okay. Hello, Benji and Samopa. I really enjoy this segment, especially the skit play. You guys are hilarious.
True.
By the way, for the situation, here it goes. Both of you are playing basketball, along with some of your friends, when a group of pretty girls arrived who are going to watch you play. Then, there's this one girl who caught both of your eyes. What song are you going to sing, play, or play to impress the girl? I think the writers took Mysel's story and then kind of changed it up a little.
They fixed it up a little bit.
Yeah, to make it more fun. So, Mysel, we're here with you, but we're all part of this, so we made it fun. Can't wait to
be excited. Yeah, who's going to be the girl today? Of course, it's going to be a girl. We'll find out soon. All right, so, are you ready to act?
Oh, man.
Let's do it. Can we get that music?
우연히 내게 오나 봐 봄 향기가 보여 너도 같이 오나 봐 저 멀리서 네 향기가 설레는 코끝에 나의 입술에 괜찮은 느낌 이 떨림 나도 몰래 우연히
우연히 내게 오나 봐 봄 향기가 보여 나도 몰래 우연히 봄 I guess it was a good idea to come to the park for a walk, but I should be on a date with a guy I like on a day like this. Why is it so hard to get a boyfriend?
Should we play here today?
Yeah, I'll show you what's good.
What? Benji, you can't talk about basketball without talking about me. We belong together. You still have to answer my calls even if you lose today, all right?
I mean, dude, stop calling me. Anyway, we haven't even started yet. What makes you so sure? I mean, let's make a bet then. You decide on the rules because there's no way I'm going to lose.
Yeah, right. He'll regret it, man. It wouldn't be a bet if the loser didn't have to do anything really embarrassing. I have an idea.
I don't know. Okay, I'm getting nervous, but okay, what are the rules?
Okay. Benji, you see that girl singing to herself? That girl over there? Oh, man. The loser has to ask that girl to buy him a drink, okay?
What? I mean, she's gonna think he's crazy. Oh, well, whatever. There's no way I'm gonna
lose. No, it's the game. You gotta do this.
Yeah, I'm good.
Let's do it.
Ooh, Benji the star. He shoots again. He scores.
Man, what are you talking about?
Whew.
Here comes Sam with the ball. He shoots, fadeaway, and a three-pointer.
Wow. Oh, there's a basketball court here. Wow, those two guys are really at it. Let me watch them for a while. Oh, wow, they look really good.
Is that girl looking at us?
I can't stop watching them, especially him. Who is he?
I think she's looking at us over
there. I feel strange. My heart's thumping. Just looking at the guy. This is so weird. I've never met that guy before.
Boom, boom. Crossover.
I'm playing. Will I regret it if I left without saying anything? Oh, my God. I didn't even realize I have a cold drink in my hand. And I'm walking towards him right now. He looks shocked. Oh, my God. He's so cute. It's okay. Just be chill and say hi.
y'all, what's up, girl?
Hey.
I just wanted to get to know you. Would you care for a cold drink?
Yeah, what?
I mean, she's this asking girl, for I you,
mean,
Benji.
She's asking me, but I mean, actually, you were going to add something at the
end. No, so hold on. First of all, in this story, there are three people.
Yes.
There is Sam.
Uh-huh.
There's Benji.
Uh-huh.
And there's Benjina.
Yes.
So, you guys... Okay.
Okay.
I think they got the story. So, me and Benji were playing basketball.
Mm-hmm.
And this girl has been walking around the park looking for a boyfriend
because
the weather's so nice and she wants to go on a date.
Exactly.
We weren't even interested, but the girl starts walking towards us.
Mm-hmm.
And then she asks us, if you want a cold drink, and then
we're just like,
we're just like, what?
All right, so you know, this is based on the thing that our MA fam, myself from the Philippines, sent us. Thank you so much.
Thank you, myself.
And in a lot of cases, romance blossoms when you get butterflies in your stomach.
Yep.
And in this case, I feel like maybe the guy would get a little nervous, maybe.
I think it's been years since I felt butterflies in my stomach. But,
really? What about when we first met?
It wasn't butterflies, man. It was competition. Me and you, M.A. Men and music.
It's not a competition when I always win, though.
Oh, man. Oh, I gotta win this, guys. Guys, help me. Dude. Oh, my God.
All right, so, continuing on. Have you ever, like, has a girl ever gotten you a drink?
A few drinks.
A few drinks?
A few drinks.
Oh, so this is not in the park.
No.
Right,
how about you?
No, I mean, you know.
I don't think girls actually come up.
If, I don't like, think girls, wanna, like, do you want drinks.
Do you want a drink?
I mean, maybe in, like, elementary school.
Yeah.
I mean, like...
Or the other way around, like, at a club or something.
No, not even at a club. That's
a guy usually.
That would be weird if that happened.
Yeah.
Anyway, so, it's time to reveal the final music selection of Sam. And
what if you were in this situation,
uh-huh.
and the drink wasn't for you, but it was for me? How would you feel?
I would feel good.
What?
You know what? I'm not gonna lie. Okay, let's say...
I wouldn't lie. No, yeah.
A girl comes up, and she gives you the drink. I'm gonna be chill about it, you know? Oh, I guess this girl, you know, she got the hots for Sam. But inside, I'll be like, damn, I got up my game, you know what I'm saying? I mean, what about you?
Me?
A girl comes out, she gives me the drink, and she's like fawning over me. She's like, oh my God, you're so cute.
나한테 안 줄 거면 가. I'll be like, if it's not for me, leave. It's for me.
So selfish.
I'm playing, come on, man.
Be a wingman.
I'm playing.
All right, so for the final music selection, to rephrase the scenario again, briefly, it's a girl sees two guys playing basketball and falls for one of them.
Uh-oh.
It's not quite sure who's who, but she goes up to them with a cold drink and she asks the guy she likes out. So, what is your song of choice as the final music selection for
my
this situation?
My song selection is 난 여자가 있는데 이러면 안 되는데 너만 박진영's 난 여자가 있는데.
So you have a girlfriend?
I'll be like, I have a girl. I'm sorry. I have it with Benji.
Oh. Okay, you know what? I'm going to tell you what. When it comes to, of course, you know, getting the girl and the girl comes up to you, you have a feeling. And you know what that feeling is? That feeling is, I'm the man.
Oh.
So I chose the song, The Man by Alla Black, which goes like, go ahead and tell everybody.
Oh,
I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about, right? That feeling.
난 여자가 있다고.
I mean, that's your problem, man. This girl comes up with a drink, and it's, you know, when you get that drink, how do you feel? Come on, be honest with yourself, man. Even if you have a girlfriend, if you get that drink, you're going to feel pretty good about it. You mean, I still got it.
Definitely.
All right, so now that PD Neem has heard our final music selection, it's time to select the winner of the battle, and it's drum roll, please. The winner is... Come on! Woo! Yeah, I'm the man. All right, the song is "The Man" by Alla Black. We'll hear it and be right back. The song you just heard was "The Man" by Alla Black, and this was the final selected song from Benji. That's right, I'm the winner. Congratulations! How does it feel? I feel amazing. You know what? I feel like I'm the man. I'm the man. I'm the man. You know what I'm saying?
I feel more like a loser now.
You know, next time you should, you know, when Sam comes on, they should play your theme song. Loser, 외톨이, 상처뿐인 걱정이, 더
대박.
You know what I'm saying?
had a good day today, Benji.
Of course, you know, I always have a good day.
You're on a roll.
That's right. And so, of course, we have to hear why he selected this song as the winner.
Huh?
And
but that's true, man.
It is true.
He's a player.
He's a player.
He's a player.
He got the game. He said, at that moment, even if you have a girl, you don't have a girl.
Wow, that's crazy.
I mean, he knew what's up, man.
Experience. When you get that age and you've been with so many women, it's like you know what to do.
You know what they call that here in Korea? They say 고수.
고수.
Expert.
고수님이시다.
고수님. So another win for Benji. So that gives us
2-1.
I mean, you know, Sam, I have a lot of outfits in mind. You know, I've been reading a lot of...
Oh, my gosh. Please,
women's fashion magazines.
Please.
Just for you.
I can't believe I'm going to go on live with, like, girls dressed on. That's crazy.
You have to.
No, if I lose.
You are going to lose.
No, if you lose,
I mean, Sam, okay, I'm not going to
get your sports bra, bro.
I've said this before. I haven't said this before just because, you know, we're tight, you know, you're a bro.
Huh?
But, you know, when it comes to talking, I've got a smoother game than you. I'm not gonna lie.
You wish five would have win.
I mean, I'm just saying, you know, when it comes to the explanation, the song's important, but you gotta be like, you gotta touch their heartstrings, man.
Guys, I'm a very smooth talker, but when I get in this booth with Benji, he has his game, so I'm gonna admit it, he's good. Girls,
I got the game on
be
lock.
Careful. Watch out for this guy.
What's
don't
the
let him smooth talk you.
There's nothing to smooth talk. Ladies, you know my number. Or no, you don't, actually. Anyway, so actually, it is time to wrap things up for today.
Man, every hour goes by so quick.
It is fast. Wow. It's because we actually don't talk for an hour. We should extend this corner to an hour.
An hour?
An hour. We can do it, right?
Can we?
I don't know, actually.
I hope.
I hope.
Wish.
There's like no emotion. I hope. I wish. Maybe. I don't know. All right, so, you know, before we wrap things up,
yep.
Anything else you want to, you know, talk about your new song or anything?
Please take a look and listen to my new single, Calling Me. Tune into MA every Monday through Friday.
And Calling Me is a true story.
Yes,
with a slight twist.
And next week, I'll be back with a win, so.
You better be.
Watch out.
Because if you don't, we're at 3-1.
Oh, my
gosh. And you know what 3-1 is?
I can't believe that.
It's the number of days in January.
Oh, my gosh.
And March.
Oh, my
gosh. All right, so sending Sam out, we'll listen to the song, Heartbeat Song by Kelly Clarkson. And as always, of course, Sam, I will see you in 7 days.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. If you get a cute girl's number on the bus, go ahead and take a picture and send it to me. Bye. The song you just heard was Heartbeat Song by Kelly Clarkson. And it's now time to reveal the answer for AA Music Quiz from the first hour. And the answer is... A. A lot of people sent us the right answer, and we'll post our winner on our message board after the show. Remember, if you see your name up there, please send us a message with your name, address, phone number, the date you were chosen, and email address on our message board under the title Winner. Our AA Music Quiz present is Walk the Moon's album, Talking is Hard, provided to us by Sony Music. And let's share some more messages sent in to us by our listeners with Message Time. Berwan Tiskaya from Turkey checking in saying, Hi, DJ Benji. Happy Tuesday. I am, of course, very happy because we had Sam in the studio. And I always have fun when Sam is in the studio because we tight. It's not a bromance. It's a bro friendship. Yeah. Park So-yoon from Korea saying, Benji, Opa, how is your dad? I heard that he was on the program at some point, and he's cute. Don't say that. Don't say that's weird. Does he still listen to you every day? Did he ever say anything about what you said during the show? My mom always yells at me for stuff I say when I talk on the phone with my friends. I guess it's a little different. In any case, thanks, Opa, for being so cute and handsome. I mean, not so much. I mean, he was really cool. He had a lot of fun. And my parents actually do listen to the radio a lot, so once in a while I'll get a message from them saying like, hey Benji, you shouldn't say this, or Benji, you should be nicer to your guests, and I say, but overall, you know, I'm always focusing on, you know, making sure everyone's happy, so that includes my parents, and I'm working on making sure they're happy as well. Alright, now let's check out two songs. The first song is 우리 집 by 2PM, followed by 동네 술집 by 허각 and 정인. And it's time to say goodbye. Our last song for today is When We Were on Fire by James Bay. This was Benji of B.I.G. And as always, I'll be back.